salts. So whenever we talk about the salts, we must know how the salts are prepared. So salts are prepared by the neutralization reaction of the acid and the base. So when we have an acid, it reacts with the base. So they both neutralize the effect of each other. That means they cancel out the effect of each other, and we will get a neutral salt, or a salt which is neither acidic nor basic. Sometimes we get an acidic salt, sometimes we get the basic salt. These are the classification of salt which we will discuss today. We will get salt and water. This reaction is known as a neutralization reaction. Now, the salt or the type of the salt depends on the acid and the base. And this classification tells us that there are three important types of salts. So, we will discuss them one by one. So, the first important classification of salts is the classification of neutral salt. So when a neutral salt is prepared, it is actually manufactured when we have a strong acid and a strong base. So when strong acid and strong base react together, they will neutralize the effect of each other, and in the end we will get a neutral salt. So for example, if I have a strong acid, that is hydrochloric acid, to be reacted with a strong base, that is NaOH, I will get a neutral salt, that is NaCl. So NaCl, that is sodium chloride, is referred to as a neutral salt. This was the first important classification of the salts. In the second classification, it is basically an acidic salt. So acidic salt is that type, or those types of salts which are actually manufactured when we have a strong acid reacting with a weak base. So for example, if I have a strong acid, that is hydrochloric acid, reacting with a weak base, that is aluminium hydroxide. Aluminium hydroxide, AnOH whole thrice, I will get the acid which is actually aluminium chloride, AlCl whole thrice. Because in this case the acid is stronger, so the effect of the stronger element, that is in this case it is acid, that will be reflected in the category of salt, and hence it will become an acidic salt. The third important classification is the basic salt. So basic salt is basically those types of salts in which we have a weak acid and reacting with a strong base. So when either of the element, that is acid or base, is stronger, that effect will be reflected in the type of salt. Like in this case, the stronger part was the acid, and hence the salt is acidic. But in the third case, the stronger part is base, and hence the salt is a basic salt. Like for example, if we have acetic acid, that is CH3COOH, and we have a strong base, that is sodium hydroxide, we will get a basic salt, that is sodium acetate, CH3COOH. And this is sodium acetate. So we have now discussed the three important classifications of salt depending upon the category of the acid and base, which of them is stronger. There is one more important classification, or we can say there is one more characteristic on which we can define acid, basic and neutral salt, and that is the replaceable hydrogen. So in those salts, if we have a replaceable hydrogen left, is referred to as an acidic salt. Let us now take an example of each of these salts. So for example, if I have the same case, that is NaCl, there is no hydrogen left in this compound. That means all the hydrogen present in the acid has been utilized. That only means that the basic part was enough to neutralize the acidic content of this salt. This is only possible if we had a strong base and a strong acid. That is why NaCl, or we can also say sodium sulfate, which is actually manufactured from sodium hydroxide and sulfuric acid, is also a neutral salt. Because in both of these salts, we don't have replaceable hydrogen. All the hydrogen which actually comes from the acid has been utilized. Now coming on to the acidic salt, if we talk about sodium hydrogen sulfate, that is NaHSO4, you can clearly see that we have one hydrogen left that could be replaced. That could be replaced means that the base was not enough to neutralize this hydrogen ion. That means some hydrogen ion is left, and hydrogen ion comes from the acid. That is why sodium hydrogen sulfate is an acidic salt. Now coming on to the basic salt, the best example is lead oxychloride. That is lead oxychloride. Lead oxychloride. In this case, as we can see, the OH part is always, OH negative part comes always from the base. That means some of the OH part has been still left. This is only possible when the acid was not enough to neutralize this base, which means that acid was the weaker part and base was the stronger part. So these are the three important classifications of the salt. We have discussed them depending upon the strong part of acid or the strong part of base. Also, we have discussed them on the classifications of the replaceable hydrogen. If there is no replaceable hydrogen left, it becomes a neutral salt. If there is replaceable hydrogen left, it becomes an acidic salt. If there is replaceable hydroxyl ion, it becomes a basic salt. There is one more category of the salts, that is the double salt. So double salts are those salts which contains two or more positive or negative ions. The best example of a double salt is potash alum. So we have potash alum. So the formula for potash alum is K2SO4.Al2SO4⁾ .24H2O. This .24H2O means these are the water of crystallization. That means this water molecule are attached to this compound, which is actually potash alum. Now when you make the ions of this potash alum, you will get from this compound, you will get K twice positive, SO4 twice negative. So we can say that we got K positive and SO4 twice negative. In this case, we get Al thrice positive and SO4 twice negative. So when you break them into different ions, you will clearly see we have two positive ions and two negative ions. That means it is actually a double salt. So till now we have discussed the classifications of the salt. Earlier we have discussed how the salt is prepared from the neutralization reaction. Then we have discussed three important categories, that is neutral, acidic and basic salt. And in the end we have discussed what are double salts. So this was everything about the concept on classification of salts.